I don't know what you've already done or tried with this, but maybe I could start off with a piece which is just to show you. I did this exercise for students. That's the idea, a finger style. But if are you guys rockers, bluesers, swing players, jazz?
All of them.
Good, great. Tell you what, I've got a new arrangement I just did, and I'll explain, if that's okay with you, I'll explain how I started and how I worked it into a finger style. Because there's a certain song, I don't know what it's like here, but in many music shops, stores in Britain and Germany, you get thrown out if you play this piece. Not Stairway to Heaven? The other one. Smoke on the Water. The other one.
Some of it too.
And I was playing around with I guess one day was kind of dreaming and was sort of found myself doing this. Genetically in there somewhere. And actually I thought, okay, why not? It'd be a good challenge. Is it possible? What could one dare to even try to do a version of this? So how do we start? I mean, it's, I think, originally in G. But it's nice when you're playing fingerstyle to have open strings to work with. That helps because it gives you more time to do other stuff. So instead of, we could do it in E, but that would be at once a shame because then we can't do it. We can't do the there. So A is good. A's got an open string. A is also very good because we've got D and we've got E. We've got open strings in the bass we can use. Helps. All helps. I could do a snare, possibility. What I noticed on YouTube, there are some really good versions out there, but a lot of them, the problem is they're doing the main riff. That's really rocky, that's really good. You know, but then the verse and the chorus comes in all kind of, it's kind of weak and watery and sort of not really all that great. So my idea was I want to make a groovy version, which is not just groovy on the riff, but groovy everywhere in the whole song. What a lot of people do, if they're doing this finger style, they often want to play the bass, the eighth bass. So, that's fine, that's good, that's nice, but problem is, what do you do when you get to the verse? So what do we do there? So, I thought I would try a different approach. I would bring in a bit less metal, a bit more JJ Cale. And how can I vary that? One thing, looking at the notes, one interesting point, these two notes are here as harmonics. Oh, okay, so what can we do? And this is always good if you've got some open string or harmonic to let it sound. And then be working the groove underneath. That's a nice effect, like two levels. So. So, what can I do to get that, make that even sound nicer? One thing, I want to make the sound bigger without changing too much. And I'm playing in A. And if I do that kind of chord, some normal A, I've got the ninth, the B here. So, my idea also for the verse, what if I... take this down. So now with the two fingers I've got a bit more like a power chord. It's fun. And now when I do this, that kind of rings, even when I'm not playing it, it kind of gives it a sort of sound. So I'm doing alternate bass. And then, and these notes are doing up here. Okay, now we're getting going. Now we're getting somewhere. If I play that a little bit quicker, maybe, then it's. The verse, which sometimes can be a problem because it kind of is a bit weaker. But what I can do, because I've got the open A, I'm going to play some these intervals. But when I play, I've got the open A in the middle, then it sounds bigger, it's got a nice kind of. Blues bend, let it go. So it's so that you've got a bluesy thing going, which sounds like finger style, but it's still smoke in the water. So we've got the chorus. And I can do a nice chord here, B flat. So I can. And arrangement up. But what I wanted to do for myself was try and get a different angle on Smoke in the Water. So I played a lyrical, very kind of ballad beginning, and using this open A, you get lovely jazzy chords without any effort at all. It's great. Great for focus. Fingerstyle piece. At the moment, I'm only using the magnetic pickup, which is just easiness sake. I have also a microphone in the guitar, and I usually take a microphone as well. And the two, mix the two, I guess, to be easy, quick, I guess, just the pickup. But the pickup is a very good one. It's a Sunrise pickup, and that sounds very acoustic, surprisingly acoustic for a magnetic pickup. I think it's very good, and that's why I like it. Because you can turn it up, and usually I take a lot of the bass and from this and the microphone, I take all the bass away, the low mids. So I've got a mixture of the two, kind of air and the wood from the microphone and the clean basses without the feedback down here. And the mixture of the two on the desk just gives me a nice sound. And this is an Avalon guitar, a Northern Ireland guitar, made in Northern Ireland. And I like it having a cutaway. I do work more these days, stuff up here as well. And what I find very useful is this. I don't know if you've seen this before, but it's just instead of a footstool, it's just very practical and very nice because the guitar sits really nicely. It's better for you, you know. That's my basic setup. I know how to EQ the pickup and the mic so that they balance out nicely on the desk. You know. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.